Thank you so much for being here tonight. Give yourselves a round of applause for coming to a live event. Thanks to the Tobin. My name is Donald Mason. I'm the executive director of the Classical Music Institute. I won't keep you too long. We've got a jam-packed slate of music and joy. For those that it's a little subliminal message, we have so many debuts happening tonight. We have our debut of our longtime assistant conductor and now conducting on stage, Leonardo Pineda, and his co-director, Daniela Diaz, have been working with the Joy students for the past several months as we've been in COVID, and tonight is gonna be showing the flourishment of what we've been working on with these kids. Tonight also we will have Francesco Fullana, who's gonna be our concertmaster and soloist, and on harp, we will have Julie Wolfolk. So give them a round of applause. And as you may have known, we played with Doc Watkins here just a couple of weeks ago. Well, it seems a couple of weeks ago. It was like 6 weeks ago. Fantastic. Anybody was here? That was a fantastic show. Yeah. We can't have enough applause tonight, so that's fine. We haven't had a lot of applause, but this is only our third show in the past 15 months. So, you know, we're kind of warming back up and getting things going again. So, but this is our debut tonight. This is our full debut tonight in the HB Performance Hall. So you all are making history as being here as witnesses to that. So, like I said, I'm not gonna keep y'all too long. Tonight we have a special presentation to give you kind of an inside the look of Joy. CMI Joy is our junior orchestra for youth. We felt that we had been working with the youth since 2016, and we didn't have a performance wing for these youth. So now, the Junior Orchestra for Youth will serve as opportunities like this for performance. So we have a short video that we'd like to introduce CMI Joy to you. So please enjoy, and enjoy the rest of the show. Lots of information on the program, as well as our digital version on the QR code. So thank you so much for coming on.
For me, it was just seeing the kids' reactions to working with incredible faculty from around the world that make up our chamber orchestra, and working with them intensely for 2 weeks. Even if they were a beginner, intermediate, advanced, whatever level they were at, they came away with such a great experience. And it was because of that was a re-motivation and energy into Classical Music Institute.
The story of CMI was really what grabbed me to come to San Antonio when I was in a transition going from leading a theater in Kentucky and looking for the next thing. I've committed myself personally to arts leadership, and I felt that this was a great opportunity to come to a place back home, and San Antonio provided this amazing atmosphere for arts and culture, and CMI has been doing such a great job over these past 5 to 6 years that I was blessed to take over and take us to the next level. San Antonio has given a lot to the arts, and we want to make sure that we're giving back as much as we've gotten.
Music is my passion, but also education plays an important role in music and what the impact we have as performers and in the community and in everything we do. But definitely music, the music making, I think the passion for me is that in all arts, but especially music, because that's what it mostly involved, is that there's never an end for the quality of music you can do.
Music has always helped me through a lot of difficult times in life. It's been a creative outlet that really saved my life in many different ways. Music had that impact for me. So it was just a creative outlet to help me process emotions. It was a way for me to take difficult times and turn them into something beautiful.
I think I'm very passionate for authenticity and for collaboration. I think those are the main components of me feeling this energy that like moves me. I think what happens inside of the thing that nobody sees, you know, what happens inside of projects, inside of productions, inside of concerts, it's so much and it's so valuable, and I think one grows so much from it, and I'm so inspired by that.
In the future and moving forward, one of my passion drivers for CMI is to make sure that every student, regardless of support at home and regardless of their economic or social standing, they have equal access to classical music education and giving them the tools to potentially grow into a musician and, if anything else, become a better patron for the arts.
Passion is something that comes with something that I really enjoy. It brings me happiness, and I want to give to the audience or to the person that is around this kind of happiness, what I feel. So this is my main point when I try to play my instrument, even playing bass guitar, whatever I'm doing. So this is the most important, and inspire other persons, be myself. Thank you.
We hope you are enjoying this performance of Symmetry of Time at the Tobin Center for the Performing Arts inside the HEB Performance Hall as part of our 2021 concert season, Harmonious Power, presented by the Classical Music Institute. I'm Donald Mason, Executive Director of the Classical Music Institute, and on behalf of the entire organization, we are beyond thrilled to have you join us for this performance. I'd like to thank our board chair, Ugo Lizarraga, our board of directors, and staff for all they do for the organization and the community. Would like to mention the gracious team at the Tobin Center, in particular Hector Gutierrez and Rick Frederick, for making this and every performance here spectacular. Thanks to David and the crew at San Genova Productions for providing live stream and recorded content for the show. CMI is a 501c3 Texas nonprofit's art organization. Our mission is to cultivate classical music education and performance as a gateway to the arts. Performance serving education. Special thanks to our 2021 season sponsors who helped make these performances possible. BEAT LLC, City of San Antonio Department of Arts and Culture, HEB Tournament of Champions, Bexar County, San Antonio Area Foundation, Texas Commission on the Arts, Escamilla and Ponick LLP, Limebarger Attorneys at Law, the NRP Group, the Fetzer Companies, H.E. Butt Foundation, Minnie Stevens Piper Foundation, Muriel F. Siebert Foundation, Monocle LLC, Broadway Bank, and S. Ragnar Photography. Thanks to all of our student sponsors for the 2021 CMI Ascend program, concluding with the student and faculty concert on June 25th at the Edgewood Theater for the Performing Arts. If you are interested in sponsoring a student, or if you've been inspired by tonight's performance, visit our website, cmi-sa.org, and give a donation that is meaningful to you. I personally thank you for your gracious gifts. Thanks to Paul Montalvo, our co-founder and artistic director, for creating such a wonderful music experience for us all. Thank you for our performers for sharing their gifts with us. And major kudos to our conductor, Leonardo Pineda, who had his CMI debut this evening. Last but not least, please give applause for our incredible CMI Joy Junior Orchestra for Youth Players. Tonight marks the first of many concerts to come from CMI Joy. As a parting note, CMI has a slew of upcoming shows this month at the Carlos Alvarez Studio Theater here at the Tobin Center for the Performing Arts. June 16th, Sung and Unsung Harmonies. June 17th, Melodious Mediterranean. June 20th, Alliance of Animals and Nature. June 26th, Infinite Roots. Be sure to visit our website for more information, cmi-sa.org. Without further ado, let's get back into Symmetry of Time from the Classical Music Institute. Enjoy the rest of the performance, and welcome back to the stage our concertmaster and soloist, Francesco Fullana.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.